In this video, we have given that sine inverse 1 by iota times g minus 1, where g is non-real, can be the angle of a triangle if option A is real g is equal to 1 and imaginary g is equal to 2, option B is real g is equal to 1 and imaginary g is greater than 0 and less than or equal to 1, option C is real g plus imaginary g is equal to 0, and option D, none of these. So, suppose this is any triangle, and this angle is theta, then according to the question, sine inverse 1 by iota times g minus 1, it is the angle of a triangle. And since theta is the angle of a triangle, then we can say that theta should be real. And if we have given that sine inverse A is equal to theta, then we can say that theta should belong from minus pi by 2 to pi by 2. Because it is the range of sine inverse function. For example, if we have given that sine theta is equal to A, then we can say that A should belong from minus 1 to 1 if theta is real, because it is the range of sine function. In the same way, range of sine inverse function is from minus pi by 2 to pi by 2. And the domain of sine inverse function, that is A, it should belong from minus 1 to 1. And since theta is the angle of a triangle, that means theta cannot be negative or 0. So if we have sine inverse A is equal to theta, then the possible value for theta is from open 0 to pi by 2. And since theta is from open 0 to pi by 2, that means A should belongs to open 0 to 1. And in place of A, we have 1 by iota times g minus 1. So, 1 by iota times g minus 1, it should belong from open 0 to 1. And if we take g is equal to x plus iota y, then we get 1 by iota times g is x plus iota y minus 1, it should belong from open 0 to 1. And it is 1 by iota times and x minus 1 plus iota y should belong from open 0 to 1. And it is x minus 1 by iota plus iota y by iota will be y should belong from open 0 to 1. And in right hand side, this is real and y is also real. That means y should belong from open 0 to 1. And x minus 1 by iota is imaginary. That means x minus 1 by iota should be equal to 0. And from here we get x minus 1 is equal to 0 and x is equal to 1. And x is real g, that is equal to 1. And y is imaginary g, that is greater than 0 and less than equal to 1. So the correct option is option B.